Okay, this is an Obsidian knowledge graph automatically created by AI. And the map is not the only thing you get. We also have a clear learning roadmap, clearly explained section by section with key concepts and various articles and their reference links as well. Addition to that, you will also have an index page that for you to complete the notes of each key concepts. For me, I personally, I cannot think of any other ways simpler than this for you to learn a new topic. In this video, let me show you the simple setups that could help you get the similar learning roadmap within 10 minutes. Hi friends, my name is Tony. I'm an AI engineer and tech nerd enthusiastic in productivity hacks. I guess you may have seen prompt tricks and tips to ask GPT to teach you something new. But how about serious topic researching and structured learning process with no applications like Obsidian? Recently, I found that combining Google Gemini DeepResearch and Obsidian, you can save loads of time to teach yourself any topic. Today's sharing will include two major parts that can help you learn anything faster: topic research with Google Gemini, building Obsidian knowledge graph with AI in Cursor. Okay, if you want to learn anything from scratch, the first thing you will do is research relevant learning materials from online, then try to piece together various fragmented information to create your study guide. This will take you days or even weeks of effort to research. But what if I'm telling you that this can be done in minutes with Google Deep Research? So, what is Deep Research? So, Deep Research is a function that's supported in Google Gemini application. It is hidden below here. Okay, let me explain in a slide. So, traditionally, when we search anything online, and a search engine like Google will help us search relevant website, or if you use Perplexity, an AI search engine, it will look for website and read relevant materials and pick it out for you. But that is only the start. So imagine that you have a smart research assistant that they do not only use Google or Perplexity to complete their research, they're also planning how to do the job better. So here comes the deep research. It is an AI agent in information searching. So as a user, you will ask a question, say, what is artificial intelligence? Then Google Gemini will create a plan first, and you, as the master, will review the plan to see whether it is good for you or not. If you think the plan is good enough, it will follow the research plan, search online, read the materials, and write a report for you to review. So let me show you how to do it. Say, I would like to know everything about the starship. You can simply ask, would like to know about starship of space X. Okay. So currently, the AI behind this is thinking of a research plan could help you better. So, oh, so it will find information about the SpaceX Starship program, including its goals and current status. So this is the first research target. Then it will find articles and news report on recent Starship development, including test flights and upcoming mission. Then find information of the technical specs of Starship, the size, the capability, and find information about potential applications as well. And last but not the least, are the environmental impacts, the potential challenges and risks associated with Starship as well. So the AI create a plan for us. If you don't like this plan, you may be edit as well. So I say I will like to edit the plan. So I would like to know about the Elon Musk's vision on Starship as well. All right, so we have an updated research plan. So at the, I think at the last action point, it added final information about Elon Musk's vision on Starship. The sixth task above is the same. All right, okay, now we can click the start. So while the Google Gemini is doing deep research for us, it will search online, read all the relevant articles, and analyze the content. Then we'll get back to you a full report for you to review. So seeing it's researching for 49 pages, okay, 60 pages or even more. So if you want to learn any area, any task, any topic you are interested in, this is the perfect tool. It's that I will let you know when the research is finished. You can leave this chart in the meantime. So, okay, so let's have a quick look at the example I will use later. So if you want to create a learning map from Google Deep Research, this is the prompt I use. If I want to learn what is large language model and how can I use large language model build AI application, would you please create a learning roadmap for me? Okay, so under this prompt, Gemini's task is not only create a research report, but also to write a learning roadmap for you based on the research result. So it lists a research plan for me, then write this learning roadmap. It is called the learning roadmap from basics to building AI applications. It was separate into sections, introduction to large language model. There are key concepts you should know and the articles that it found relevant. And you can definitely click the articles, including YouTube videos as well. You see the videos, introduction to large language model, Google Cloud, and YouTube. Let's click this. See.
Hello and welcome to Introduction to Large Language Model.
Great. All right. So if you don't want to read articles, you can definitely check those videos later. Let's check whether our Starship report is completed. Okay, it's really close. Great. It has been completed. Okay, let's check the report. SpaceX Starship reaching for the stars and Mars with Elon Musk's vision. Wow, the title is tempting. All right, say Starship development and test flight. I will leave the link to this article below and you can definitely check this out. So let's check how many sections it have. Starship development and test flight, recent development, flight 567, and upcoming missions as well. So take an example, SpaceX outlined several key missions for Starship. Orbit refueling demonstration, wow. Uncrewed lunar demo, wow. Wow, this is exciting too. All right, and you will have those specs of Starship and internal design, structure features, a lot of detailed information. All of this information was actually not made up from Google's Gemini. It was from reliable sources. You can take a quick look at this. They are Wikipedias. They have information from Starship official website. They also use Reddit as information resource as well. And of course, we got YouTube videos and NASA report. So I would say, when I was a student, if I have a tool like this, I would definitely have higher marks of my assignment, because this is amazing. You have those multimedia resources from different information sources and combine together to create you this single report in just a few minutes. Additionally, if you have Google Drive, you can open in Docs and you can edit, you can export the report as well. Since Obsidian use Markdown format, you can choose download with Markdown. Okay, it is downloaded. Let's open it. And we have Markdown file. Okay, I have already imported the learning roadmap as a Markdown file to the Obsidian. As you can see that we already have a well-researched learning roadmap. But having a roadmap is only the beginning. That's why we need to use Obsidian to help us to learn. So the major reason why I love Obsidian is that you can write your note cards each time by focusing on one concept. Then you can easily find and build connections between your new notes and existing one. With time, you will have your own personalized knowledge graph like this on any topic you are interested in. This idea was made popular by book How to Take Smart Notes, Learning by Writing. There are loads of great videos on YouTube right now talking about this, so I will not explain it in details, but focusing on one pain point, slow. Yes, it works, but it will take you a lot of time to build it up. And sometimes when you are facing a strange topic or an area, you will feel very uncomfortable. You just don't know where to start. The best way is to buy a textbook. In our case, what we need to do is to extract those knowledge points from the learning roadmap and make each one into note cards for us to write learning notes. Now this process can be fully automated by AI. Okay, now we use Cursor to open up Obsidian file folders. Regarding why and how we use Cursor to operate Obsidian files, you can refer to the link below. You can see that this is the markdown file from Obsidian. And for each section, we will have an index node introduce the concept and provide the links to the note card we need to fill. But how can we create it automatically? This is the part we need to involve AI. All right. So the process is very simple. It only involves two steps. The first step is to create index nodes, and the second step is to create a backlink from index nodes to the roadmap. What I will do here is that I will delete all the files. And remove those backlinks. Okay, now we only have one roadmap nodes in my Obsidian folder. Let's use my prompt to try again. This is a learning roadmap report. I need you to do the following. Step one, based on the learning roadmap, create a list of markdown files for each topic. For each topic file, write an introduction and a list of knowledge points. Each knowledge point title should be written in double square bracket. You can simply use Cloud Sonnet 3.5. Then submit. Okay, now we have an AI is creating each note files for you. Okay, we have the ethical part, the introduction part. This is the file created by AI. Okay, it has been completed. We already have those notes created with introduction and note card link listed inside. What you need to do is simply accept all. Right, you already have those files. The next step is to add a backlink on the roadmap file so we can use it conveniently. This is the prompt. Add your created file name list in roadmap file. Place them under each topic. Say related. Remember, use double bracket to quote the file name. Okay, submit. Let's see how it works. Okay, it seems that it got wrong. Create new file for me. No worries. Let's update the prompt. All right, let's submit again. So in this case, you will click continue and revert. So it will undo the previous task AI agent did and try again. All right, working. Great. It even added an emoji here, related detailed notes. Cool. Good job. So what you do, accept it, and everything is done. So this can be done in a couple of minutes. Let's track the Obsidian file, see how it goes. In Obsidian, this is the original node, LLM, Learning Roadmap. And here's the link, edit. We can jump to the index node, where it introduced the concept here and have all those key concept knowledge for you to fulfill. We can try our graph view as well. So this graph view only uses nodes in my notes folder. So what I do, I will move those index nodes into notes. See how it goes. Great, we have our roadmap. Now, if you want to learn any new concept about the large language model, you could have a quick look around it. If you have read something about testing automation, you could simply click it and write your learning notes here. Step by step, with a clear roadmap, you can learn anything faster. Okay, this is today's sharing. So we do an AI deep research with Google Gemini. Then we use Cursor AI to build Obsidian Knowledge Graph. Thank you guys for your time. If you like my video, please hit the subscribe button and click the thumbs up. If you don't like, tell me how to improve it. Thank you very much for your time.